The list has been contested. Nobody likes the list. They all think it's trash, and therefore we're going to talk about it and try it. We're going to try again, essentially. We're going to try again, and today we're talking about Jimmy Eat World. And I'll say this, in defense of the group that initially did it. For Leah, I believe she was in the front half of the discography. And Keith, he was completely new to the band. And while technically speaking, it was a discovery for me as well, it was clear that I had listened the shit out of the discography and fallen in love with the band. So, like, it was brutal for me because, like, I felt like I knew the band. And I will also put this out there. I still believe in my 20. I still feel like I had banger after banger after banger Jimmy Eat World tunes on my 20. I think it's the most proud of a list I've ever been. And then I think that's what hurt about us not nailing it. So today we have brought together Cord.
What's up?
We have brought together Joe.
How are you now?
And we brought in Jason.
Oh, hey there.
And so here's what we're going to do. So I'm going to lay out this list, and then each of you can get a turn at saying what you think was wrong. Not necessarily song choices, but what you think is wrong. And then we will start to rebuild our list. So we've got A Praise Chorus, Digits, Lucky Denver Mint, 10, Bleed American, Here It Goes, Hard Is Hard to Find, Sure and Certain, Pretty Grids, In the End Is Beautiful. So, Cord, what did we get wrong here?
So when I listened to this episode, full disclosure, I did not make it to the top 10. Mostly because I was so appalled that 23 was not mentioned by anybody. I think there's a lot of really good stuff on that list. Like, Bleed American, there's something to be said about that. I love that whole record a lot. Lucky Denver Mint and 10 are both, like, really, really good bangers off of Clarity. But I don't know. I just think one thing that you kept saying during the Jimmy Eat World episode was they sound like a CW band.
Yes.
Which I hate that I agree with it. Like, I hate how accurate that is. But I think Jimmy Eat World plays best when they are, you know, the quintessential, like, influential emo band that they always have been. Mm-hmm. And I don't know how to describe it. I feel like it misses the mark on what I feel Jimmy Eat World is best represented by.
I got you.
Yeah.
All right. Joe, same question. What did we get wrong?
I mean, basically kind of everything that Cord just said, I don't need to repeat it, but I feel the same way of, like, I'm pretty sure. Yeah, with the list just went over, I don't think I heard anything off of Futures. And right. I feel like Futures is such a good fucking record. And also, I couldn't remember if this episode came out before or after Surviving dropped.
Before,
Okay, all right. So, okay, before. That makes sense then. But yeah, nothing off of Futures. And I don't remember the episode, but I don't even remember if anything came up and it just missed or what.
Oh,
but,
for sure.
Okay. Yeah, I was just like, how in the actual fuck did something for Futures not get on there? Specifically Futures itself.
Yeah.
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 That's how I feel.
All right, Jason?
So I completely agree with Joe. My favorite album from them is probably Futures. Like, that's the one that hooked me and made me go back and listen to any more than radio play stuff. And that's just the one where, as I was listening to it, again, I was just like, why is Futures being ignored? The whole album is just like, one here, one there. There were a few of them, and I mean, to leave off Radiohead sometimes is fun, but I think if we're making a list of first songs you should listen to of a band, sometimes you need one. So something like Sweetness, I felt like leaving it off is just saying like we're ignoring this one.
Yeah,
I will say this to be fair to specifically
to be fair to
Keith specifically, being that he was new to the band, it was. And this was before I kind of developed, you know, let's have a cutoff point and, you know, let's really like hone in on what we're including. It was a lot. And the band definitely benefited from me falling the fuck in love with them. Like I listened, my 20, I had made months and months and months in advance. And it wasn't even necessarily for the show. I was just putting my favorites through, and I'd fallen in love with all those songs. Now that said, the list specifically, the only one that we can't touch is A Praise Chorus. A Praise Chorus is in because it got through unanimously on the first pass. So that means the other nine are essentially up for grabs. So let's go through the other nine and see if there's any that we want to keep and then build from there. So the remaining nine are Digits, Lucky Denver Mint, 10, Bleed American, Here It Goes, Hard Is Hard to Find, Sure and Certain, Pretty Grids, The End Is Beautiful. Anybody?
I'd say you got to keep Bleed American.
Yeah,
I agree.
Okay.
I also think Lucky Denver Mint is a good representation for Clarity.
Yeah, I have Lucky Mint on that list that I just made also.
Okay. So keeping Lucky Denver Mint and keeping Bleed American. All right, so
I also had Digits on mine to keep.
Okay.
I didn't have Digits, but I did have Sure and Certain.
Okay.
Yeah, that's the one that I picked, Sure and Certain.
I feel
as well.
Yeah, so looking at this 10, there's three from Integrity Blues, and I completely disagree that it should be three.
That is one of their records that I listen to the least. I love Integrity Blues, but yeah.
And I think Sure and Certain's the one if we're going to keep something from Integrity Blues. So
yeah.
That's fine.
I agree.
And so that gives us four. And so that brings us back to Digits. Is that just kind of
I'm fine with Digits. I don't not like the song. I don't know. I just feel like it's, I don't know how to say it other than just like, it's so old Jimmy though.
That's fair.
You know, I don't know. I don't know. Like, I feel they were, that's what they started as, but they didn't necessarily, they kind of essentially kept the same idea of Jimmy Eat World, but I feel like they just evolved so much more from Digits as they went along. I guess that's the best way I could say it.
I haven't really given a lot of listens to Static Prevails. I remember the one track that stood out to me from that record was Episode 4.
Mm.
And that, like, I don't know, I feel like that whole record in general is very much a product of its time. Like, that sounds like the underground emo scene in 1996.
Oh, like, I definitely agree.
Sounds like a band that would have gone on tour with Mineral, you know?
Yeah, this would be a Promise Ring and them and a couple other little ones. But I also think I'm okay with getting rid of Digits, because if I say, listen to my band and it's got an 8-minute song, that's not the one I'm going to listen to.
Yeah.
And yeah, you know,
something could be said here, too, because it did make the original 10. So we're not completely discounting it. And you went to bat for it, so it's getting like that secondary nod of, I feel like you weren't completely off base with having this one. So, and I mean, we can come back to it here, you know, so this is what we've got so far in the list contested: A Praise Chorus, Bleed American, Lucky Denver Mint, and Sure and Certain, which means there's six songs up for grabs. And now we'll play like we normally would. And I had this in the first one. I couldn't believe that it whiffed. To me, it's quintessential. To me, the dribble, the matching of the guitars and the kick. This is, I don't understand how this could miss. Futures itself, the single, Futures.
100%.
Obviously.
Yeah.
That riff is undeniable, dude.
Like, dude, I Every time I hear that song, I'm just jamming my fucking head like, ah, fuck yeah.
Yeah.
Come on. I don't know how many times I've listened to this since getting into this band. Like
honestly, if you're gonna say banger, Futures is a fucking banger, dude.
Absolutely.
Yeah.
Absolutely.
Seriously.
Like,
Futures is such a banger.
It's got everything you want too. Like, it's got the matching the dribble here at the beginning. Ba boom, boom boom, boom boom. Oh, it's got like this great heartbeat to it, and then it's got these guitars layered over it. And then lyrically, like, what else do you want from a song?
Yeah, I hate that I'm about to say this because it's such a like 2010 word, but the chorus to this song too is like, there's no other way to say it. It's epic. Like, mm-hmm. that's the feel of the chorus, and that's such a Jimmy Eat World thing to make. You know, they have those parts of their songs that are so like kind of larger than life.
Mm-hmm.
Sounds like this, like the ending scene to a movie or something, and that's definitely Futures.
Absolutely, and it's the one. It's one for certain, like, you could hear in a CW show, but this, but to me, this one isn't that. Like, and I don't mean that as a negative thing, by the way. I don't know if anybody remembers that, but to me, this isn't that, but you could hear it there. Whereas there's some songs where you hear them and it's like, no, that's exactly what that is. So, all right, well, we're in agreement. Futures gets through, and that gives us 5. Chord.
I think one that I want, I mean, I feel like Sweetness is another one. I know we've already got a couple from Bleed American, but, you know, I feel like Sweetness.
I'm with you. Cause just, yeah, I mean, you know, radio song, but still, like, it has, I don't know, other than just, it's fucking Jimmy Eat World. Like, it's such a Jimmy Eat World song. That's the only way that I can say it. I don't have any other words for it, but it's just them, like, you know?
And I feel like on Bleed American, like, that song is one of the songs that pretty accurately represents, like, the bleed over between what they were on the first couple of records and what they would become. You know, like, that's... It's such a good in between of it sounds like a 90s emo banger, but at the same time it still fits really well with Bleed American and the direction that they were going.
I think that all that's fair, and the one thing with Sweetness is it for me, I think that's the one song. No, the middle's the one song where Radio Play completely destroyed it for me. But I think I still have that kind of connection with Sweetness. I think it's a great tune. When I hear it, I'm like, yeah, I can jam to this, but it still has this negative connotation of I heard it too much. So that's the only Agreed. Reason it's not.
I respect that.
It's the only reason it's not unanimous, if you ask me. Like, I'm willing, I put it through and we can come back to it if we get up and over 10. But to me, that's why it's not unanimous. So.
For me, Sweetness is just like, you know, you get the, are you listening? Whoa. And then there's like that, just a brief little period of, and it stops. And then you get it again. And I don't know. Anyway.
Yeah. Okay. Start and stop.
Can we quick pause for like 2 seconds? I just got groceries dropped off and I gotta go grab them.
Okay.
They're sitting in the cold.
Gotcha.
Okay. I'll be right back.
Yes.
And at least I'm not getting hot and spoiled. So
that's true too. That's true too. While he's doing that, do you have any thoughts on the Sweetness, Jason?
Like I said, I was listening to it and it's kind of what I said at the beginning. It just feels like to leave that one off is to have your bias of working in radio, and it just, I listened to this too much. I just heard it too often. It's still a great song.
Yeah,
I don't know if it's my favorite one off Bleed American, but like between that Bleed American, I have one other song from that record that's my favorite, but it's one of the ones that if I play this for you, you're going to get hooked on the Jimmy World, probably. You're going to start saying, oh, let me listen to more of them.
I do think it's a bummer that that I have that negative tie to Sweet, because it is, it's a great tune. And even when it was getting played so much, I never like hated it. Like I never, like the middle I hated, and I still, it's hard to listen to the middle for me. Like it is really hard, but Sweetness doesn't have that, but it still has this, like, there's this negative tie to, you know, I maybe because it's still alive, like you can still hear it. But it's not, it's not so negative that I'm like completely dismissing it either. So it's, I don't know. Sweetness is a weird song for me. Whereas Bleed American, strangely enough, I feel like when it first came out, it got a ton of play, but because of when it came out, it kind of went away with quickness. Because I believe Bleed American released either.
Oh, right.
Yeah.
Okay, sorry.
Bleed American, I believe, released right before or right after 9/11. And so
yeah,
because of that title, it kind of disappeared into the ether.
I remember it from Van Wilder.
Same.
Yeah, they had to take Bleed American off the cover and just sell it as self-titled for a couple of years.
Yeah. And so, yeah. All right.
Well, that's shitty timing.
Yeah, absolutely. Joe.
So I've got to go with, again, because this episode released before Surviving came out. Fucking Surviving is such a good fucking album, too.
Yeah.
I have two for sure that I want to play. I know I'm probably going to hit Justin on this one, but you got to go with the title, Surviving.
Fuck yeah, you do.
It has to be there. It fucking has to.
Yeah. What? I'm curious what the other one from Surviving was.
Do you want me to say it?
Well, okay. Well, I'll wait and play mine when. Yeah.
Okay.
Then we'll see. We can fight over which Surviving track goes. I love that opening track too, though. Man. All right. Yeah.
So, like, you know, full disclosure from that album, I have a couple that I feel should be, or could be, in the top 10 of Jimmy Eat World.
Yeah, I picked.
All right. We'll yeah, probably land on one. We'll see.
Yeah. So I think the way this is going, I don't think we're gonna get all the way through 10 each, because like,
yeah.
I mean, there's conversation to be had here, but we're already at 7, and like we haven't even done a full round yet. So, maybe we'll do a couple rounds and then dump out, kind of like we would in a normal game. So, I'm pushing Surviving into the list for conversation. So, cool. Jason.
I'm gonna go with my future song, and that's Pain. That one's just the lyrics, and it just, like, it's a lie, a kiss with opened eyes, which is like, ah, it hit me too hard back when I was listening to this album.
I do like Pain, but I didn't put it on a new list.
Same.
That's, yeah, fine. I have two more from Futures that I'd be pulling for a little bit more than Pain.
I think unfortunately Pain is another one of those songs that, like, it's still hard for me. So, to me, Futures is the infinitely better song, but Pain is the one somehow that still lives. You know, you can still hear it on the radio. And again, what does radio play mean nowadays? But if I'm in the car and I turn on the radio and I hear Pain, I'm like, man, like, it immediately makes me think, but Futures was a single too. Where the fuck is that? That one's better.
So, yeah.
I
feel like Pain was on every video game that came out.
Yeah.
Yeah, it
in
was,
like, you know, 2004 or whatever.
It's these are unfair things to hold against the song, but
yeah,
that is my truth, unfortunately. So, sorry you're alone on that one, Jason.
No worries. And then maybe that's my issue for not listening to the radio, so I didn't even know it was a radio hit.
See, yeah, you know, and it is all perspective, you know, like if you don't listen to the radio and you don't know that, then you get to hear the song just as it is, which I kind of envy. All right, I'd be remiss if I didn't go with my fucking favorite Jimmy Eat World song. I was crushed when this didn't make it, and coincidentally, the name of the song is Crush.
Ooh,
I don't have it. Sorry.
Still crushing you.
Oh my
still
God.
Still crushing you.
All right. Well, I don't care. I'm playing a clip from it because now
I've
done
this.
It's
your fucking show. So
I've done this twice now, and I still can't get this song the love it deserves. Oh,
dude, Faint as Snow Keep Falling is.
God, what a line. What a line to open. And it just, I don't know, it just fucking rocks. So.
Yeah.
Like a breath. And then I learned how to play it, which kind of like really set it in stone for me. So, all right. All right. That's okay. All right, chord.
I'm going to play. Actually, I'm going to play the one that I had from Invented, which I think is an underrated album. Even for me, I don't listen to it enough. And then every time I do, I'm like, fuck, this is a good record. Coffee and Cigarettes.
Oh, motherfucker. Mm. God, yeah.
You're goddamn right.
Okay, good. I don't have it, but fuck, I love that song. I thought it was a lonely man on that. Like, that's...
I didn't have it either, but I agree.
God damn, yeah, I love that song.
Yeah, Coffee and Cigarettes is solid. So solid. Like, just, you know, Coffee and Cigarettes. Like, yeah, obviously.
Yeah, dude.
Oh, man. Like, the line, when I packed up and headed west, what is it? Like every townie kid dreams of, I packed up and headed west. A few things I had, my sister's two cassettes, like just the picture he's painting of, yeah, I'm just, fuck this. I'm out of here and I'm just going to get in my dumb car and listen to these two tapes all the way to California, yep, or wherever the fuck I'm going. And I still listen to the shit out of Coffee and Cigarettes.
Hell yeah.
All right. So it's in the conversation because two of y'all had it. And it definitely deserves to be in this next part. So, Joe.
I mean, Jimmy Eat World does fucking banger title tracks, baby. Off Chase the Light, Big Casino is my pick.
Man, I don't got that one. I think I had it on the first one, but.
I like this song almost as much as I like Futures.
Wow.
Yeah, that is a banger opening track. I did not have it, but putting this list together so quickly, I almost wish I would have gone with that one.
Sure. No, I get it. Like this one, I mean, you know, freaking, I don't know. It gives me some type of almost like a, I don't even know, nostalgia feeling is the right word, but essentially, you know, just, you know, when they call my name, fuck, I can't remember the lyrics right now, but the whole chorus of that song, like, I don't know, it gives me just that feeling of like somehow nostalgia, somehow like, yeah, I'm going to fucking be something, right? I am something, you know, I don't know.
Yeah. Yeah, that's Big Casino is one of the Jimmy Eat World songs that they have on karaoke at the bar that I go to. Oh, nice. And my friends and I do Big Casino all the time, even though nobody else in the bar knows it.
Hey, fuck them.
Yeah.
Best ones to do.
Yeah.
Yeah.
How dare you? All right. Jason?
Let's go with my favorite off of Bleed American. I'll just go Authority Song.
Oh.
No. Good pick. I don't have it, though.
Yeah, same. Same.
I do like that. I do like that song.
Yeah. I love Authority Song.
Funny looking
That's the one I felt should have been one there. Radio hits, but it wasn't.
Here, let's...
Yeah.
Man.
I just love the bounce.
Yeah,
mm-hmm.
Definitely got the bounce.
I love the two vocal tracks throughout the whole song too, where it's like he's got the one lower harmony and the one higher harmony that are the whole time.
What's funny here is like we're playing on like a lot lighter, like a lot smaller field, and it's still fucking difficult as fuck.
Yeah.
All right. And we have the advantage of like that first list exists. Okay. If I don't bring this up, I'm a complete and utter liar to myself. If it doesn't make it, I will be hurt, but I also can semi-understand. This one screams fucking CW, but I don't give a shit. It's off of Damage. It's No Never.
Nope. I don't have that one.
I don't have it.
Nope.
Okay.
Sorry, buddy.
I don't care. I'm playing some of it because fuck. It's CW as fuck. I don't care. Like, it's fucking perfect.
This might have actually been on One Tree Hill.
I wouldn't doubt it.
Yeah.
I wouldn't fucking doubt it. Like the
I can't confirm nor deny that, but yeah.
So I mean, you got this, you know, this just pretty normal verse, but to me, like, the magic lies when it explodes into the chorus. So I'm trying to, like, at least get us there so you can hear why. Here we go. Listen to this guitar. That little lick. Oh.
Yeah. That is some pop rock goodness right there.
Yeah. So, again, I'm willing to take the L on that one. All right. Chord?
I'm going to go off Surviving again, and I'm going to go with All the Way Stay.
Yes, it is.
Yep.
There we go.
That's the one that sticks out to me.
Yep. That was the first one they released, and I was like, oh, shit, I'm really excited for this record.
You know what's crazy?
Yeah, man.
Okay, good. Good. It makes it through. I don't have that one, but, like, I love the shit out of that song. So, like, I'm totally with putting that through. All right, Joe.
Oh, I'm gonna stay on Chase the Light. I honestly don't even really think this is one of their best songs, but somehow I just need it in a list. I couldn't tell you why. Always Be.
Oh. No, that one.
I don't really have. And that's okay. Like, I don't have a good reason for it. Honestly, there's just something about it that always sticks in my mind when I think about Jimmy Eat World. Like, it's just one of those songs. So if you don't have it, it's fine. But
yeah, unfortunately, nope. This is hard. Like, I'm just saying, folks, when you come at me for our list, just realize this is what happens, and this is like a much, much more condensed version. So, Jason.
Going to stick with and go back to Futures, I guess, and do Drugs or Me, which, if it's not on a CW song, should be.
Ooh.
No, I don't have that one.
Did not have that.
Yeah, I don't have that either.
All right. Let's give it a sec. All right. I'm just going to dump out because I think I got like six here. So. From Chase This Light, I got Firefight.
Nope.
Again, that one's CW as fuck. It's screen, like, I can envision a scene. Like, I can envision it's Firefight, and I can envision, like, a girl coming to the door and answering, and it's her man, like they were gonna break up, but, like, no, I'm willing to fight for this. Like, I can.
Oh yeah.
Like, I can see it. So, like, I could not get rid of that one. All right, I got from Damage, Bye Bye Love.
Nope.
Wow. Okay, that one's big for me. From Integrity Blues, You With Me.
Nope.
Nope.
From Futures, 23.
Yes.
Yes.
Oh, okay. There we go. Pretty unanimous there.
Fucking yes.
God. That was why I quit listening to that episode. It was like, no one went with 23.
What the fuck?
Yeah.
All right. And last two, I got Work.
Yep.
Oh, okay. So we have a conversation on our hands. For sure. And last but not least, Criminal Energy.
Nope.
No.
Okay, so that one I need to play a little bit because, oh, this energy is criminal. This one, I failed to see is off surviving as well. Like, how do you follow up?
A lot of fun.
Yeah, how do you follow up surviving? Like, how do you follow up that opening track? Oh, I don't know. This.
Yeah. Oh,
come on. That's good. All right. You want to dump out whatever you got there, Cord?
I think I only have two left. Your House, which is my personal favorite from Bleed American.
No, I do not.
Didn't figure I'd have any bites there, but had to throw it out there. And then what's probably my favorite off of Damage, which is Appreciation.
Mm. No.
I don't.
All right.
All right. Joe?
All I have left is My Best Theory.
Oh, okay.
Nope.
All right. And just for fun, Jason?
We've already hit everything on my list, so I didn't have anything left to go.
All right. So, well, then we only need to make one cut here, so this won't be as brutal. So here's the 11 we got, and the only one that's safe is A Praise Chorus, which does anybody actually disagree? Like, I feel like that is.
I don't disagree.
Yeah. No, that's a great song.
Okay. All right, so the 10 that we need to cut one from. Bleed American, Lucky Denver Mint, Sure and Certain, Futures, Sweetness, Surviving, Coffee and Cigarettes, All the Way Stay, 23, and Work. Anything sticking out at you there, Cord, as the one that can probably go?
God, that's hard. I think I'm leaning... Sure and Certain.
Oh, interesting. Okay. What are you thinking, Joe?
Can I skip and come back to me?
Sure. You have any thoughts, Jason? One that's...
With Cord, Sure and Certain didn't make my list, and that was one of the ones I took off the original. So, I mean, maybe if you want to say from the original that it got a couple votes, that it still should go, but that would have been mine.
Okay. To me...
All right. Well, yeah. I'm glad you said that, because it's Sure and Certain. That's what I was feeling.
Okay. Just to kind of put the hammer in it, like the only two that were even considered are Work and Sure and Certain, but I fucking love Work, so if it's between those two, I'll take Work all day every day.
Yeah.
All right, you did your best, Sure and Certain, but you're out. All right, so list has been contested, and here's what we have. A Praise Chorus, Bleed American, Lucky Denver Mint, Futures, 23, Sweetness, Surviving, Coffee and Cigarettes All the Way, Stay, and Work. And there you have it. That's a new Jimmy World list for you. All right, so that's our first crack at list contested. It'll get tighter the more we get to do it. So let me know what you think, and if there's a band that you'd like, if there's a list you'd like to contest, I guess more specifically, let me know. Subscribe, rate, comment, do all those great things. Thanks.